We were out here just a little while ago checking the sound, and the place was empty. It's a lot nicer than some people. We want to welcome tonight in our audience the Friends of Pig. All right, we're going to be playing a long, continuous show for you. However, in the middle of this long, continuous show, we're going to take a rest live on stage so we don't have to go back into the dressing room or anything. So you won't be confused, you know? His favorite sofa, his girlfriend, Squat the Magic Pig. How appropriate somehow. And that big light he uses to make home movies.
Local 327, and by means of a cute little tune that
Invent because you have to be careful with these union guys. He gave them instructions about what he wanted done with the sofa. And it went something like this. As far as vision permits, stretching all the way from Vancouver, just outside of this town. And the Lord put aside his huge cigar and decided that phase B of his operation must of necessity include in-depth briefing, during which he would whip upon the helpless, chunky little sofa the vital statistics about their forthcoming relationship. He was going to tell the sofa where it was at. And of course, because the good Lord is, in his totality and radiant magnificence like Dick Barber, extremely musical, decided he would sing the details to the sofa. So he snapped his big old fingers, platoon, and a little electric clarinet appeared from a corner of the sky and played the intro to the briefing music, which goes like this.
I am the sky. I am the water. wife of Himmelherra, who mentioned with Aljahaz in the Truman. Look at the gas, it will keep you frog and make a cheese aus den Nugget. Sister tried to uncoat this herring.
Yes, 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 the light shines down from heaven. A dense ecumenical patina at the right hand of God's big sofa. And his voice pronounced out in sheets of plywood and bales of old sport shirts. And he decided that today, this day of all days, which is simultaneously the night of all nights on the other side of where everything is happening, would be a wonderful time to have a little home movie recreation. And so he says, bring the band on down behind me, boys. And he hit a D major chord.
Bring it to me, Das Kurzarmeja.
And that means, bring unto me the short girl. Big light I use because we are going to make a home movie.
Hey!
Yeah. Thank you. You're my daughter, I realize that, and your mother realized you too the other night that you walked in on us. Thank you. played the show.
Truck, which you might have seen someplace. He's lurking over there. Give him a round of applause. Big Brother Howard. Big Brother Howard. Thank you.
It's mounted on the top, comes down, there's a little plateau area there, and growing off of that plateau is a wizened tree that looks like a little TV antenna. And the tree's name is Ethel, with two L's. And Ethel is married to Billy the Mountain. And then on the other side of the tree, it slopes down, and split is right over here. It sticks out like that. Billy has two big caves for eyes, and they're placed exactly where you would imagine they go. And he doesn't have a nose, but underneath of that, he's got this jaw, which is a clip, and it sticks out. And whenever he talks, it goes up and down 30 feet. Dust puffs out, and boulders pack up. Those are the important details of Billy's character that you have to remember. There are other things that happen later on that will be explained as they occur. Let me check my tune here. Thank you.
A mysterious wind blew in from Saskatoon. A mysterious wind should have this yesterday. We now have confirmed reports from an informed Presbyterian minister in New York City that Ethel is still an active communist. And it is this reporter's opinion that she also practices witchcraft.
It was about this time that the telephone rang inside of the secret briefcase belonging to the one mortal man who might be able to stop all of this senseless destruction and save Canada itself. Of course, you know, one mortal man would have to be Studebacher Hoch, fantastic hero of the current economic slump. And here are the details.
Shelter! shit off. What did my draft evasion?
Studebacher Rock dancing lesson and cosmic prayer for guidance and Winnipeg Ranger salute featuring Aynsley Dunbar.
Father, still reigning.
Thank you.
crazy.
Now, as you recall, building the mountain has a jaw which is a cliff. And whenever he talks or laughs, that jaw, which is a cliff, goes up and down 30 feet. And remember, Studebacher Hoch was standing on the edge of building the mountain's mouth. So that means when he started laughing, Studebacher Hoch lost his footing and fell springing 200 feet into the road below.
Oh!
simply by going down to the bacon taco shop on the lobby, buying the necessary apparatus, a packet of dried shrimp that you plug onto the little hook that you get, and you throw that out the window of your room, dangle it in the water for a while, and if you're lucky, you will be able to capture the wily mud shark, or dogfish, and as it is known in that area. Now, what will you do with a mud shark? This is one of the questions that have been plaguing civilization for thousands of years, because people found out a while back they really don't taste too good. They don't make interesting jewelry, but I took a drink like the vanilla fudge to discover the ultimate erotic use of the mud shark. A handsome gray fish about that long. Now, we don't wish to get too explicit for a Canadian audience or nothing. However, just imagine that you had got your mud shark on the end of your string, and you were smart enough to fill the bathtub with water to keep it afloat for a while. You hauled in your mud shark, you dabbled it in the bathtub until your lady friend assistant came up to the room. In this case, the marvelous young lady known as the mud shark queen. And there really is such a marvelous young lady that she wants. Well, some people like to have fountain pens squirted into their hair. Other people like to chew on shoelaces. This girl gets off behind the mud shark. And you too can get off behind the mud shark. As Mark and Howard demonstrate the problem.